Are you mixed up?
No, sir.
Are you more jumpy than you were before?
No, sir.
And how's your sleeping?
I sleep just fine, sir.
When you sleep, do you have nightmares?
Not as much as before.
You've had violent episodes.
Yes, sir, we all did.
You pulled a knife to the throat of an officer.
Will you box that out?
How would you yourself rank your overall health?
Strong.
And what about this last episode on the way home?
What episode, sir?
The episode you had on the way home here.
I don't remember an episode.
You have no memory of what happened?
We were celebrating. We were drinking and dancing, but I don't remember an episode. Was there a fight? What happened? Sir?
Let's just see if we can't help you remember what happened.
What do you do?
I do many, many things. I am a writer, a doctor, a nuclear physicist, a theoretical philosopher. But above all, I am a man.
I would like to talk to you today about cold feet and narrow minds. People of cold feet cannot move forward. People of narrow minds cannot move side to side. They both take courage. This is what I'd like to talk about.
This exercise will help you with your concentration. Look at my eyes. I want you to place something in the future for yourself that you would like to have. It's there waiting for you.
Say your name.
Freddie Quell.
Say it again.
Freddie Quell.
Might as well say it one more time just to make sure you know who you are.
Freddie Quell.
And this is where we are at. At the lowest level. To have to explain ourselves. For what? For what we do, we have to grovel. The only way to defend ourselves is to attack. If we don't do that, we will lose every battle that we are engaged in. We will never dominate our environment the way we should unless we attack.
Oh.
It's a grim joke.
Are you thoughtless in your remarks? You linger at bus stations for pleasure. Is your life a struggle? Is your behavior erratic? Are you unpredictable?
It's a horrible young man you are. This is acting like an animal. A dirty animal that eats its own feces when hungry.
I wonder how he got here and what he's after. Is it really all so easy that he just came across us? He's dangerous, and he will be our undoing if we continue to have him here.
If we are not helping him, then it is we who have failed him. Tis it not?
Perhaps he's past help. Or insane.